In this video, we are going to change our currently existing armature into an unglorified skeleton so we can play it in real time in the end of this video. So it will be an easy video to follow, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's address the elephant in the room first, which is that you will lose all your weight paintings that you've done to your character. Because obviously, if you are going to use a different skeleton, different hierarchy, and different bone quantities, and different bone names, you will not be able to transfer those weights. By that said, we will use automatic weight paint. It will help our job, but you know, automatic weight paint is kind of, you know, so-so. So we are going to need some manual tweaking, in every case. But that said, let's just really quickly start that. So we are going to render now its location. First thing you will need is this adder. I will leave a link in the description below. It's a love child of Blender Boy and CG Dive. It's a really great tool, highly recommended. And I also really recommend CG Dive's video on how to use this in depth. If you wanna know this, you should check out his videos. I will leave a link in the description. Once you install it, it will appear a game rig tool right in the sidebar. It's going to look a bit intimidating, but don't worry about that. We are only going to use a really small section of it. This is great as well, but this is not what we are looking for right now, because it will not create us an unreal skeleton. This is currently not what we are looking for. We are looking for this one. And here you can see we can change UE 4 or 5. We are going for the 5 one, and the first thing you need to do is just simply initiate mannequin. Now, you will have three kind of bone structures: tweak, deform, and unreal. Consider these three structures as layers, like in Photoshop. So first we will work with the tweak one, then we will work with the deform one, and we will work with the unreal one. First, you need to do is just hide this, select the tweak, which is already selected by default, and as you can see, it's already in pose mode. And what you'll need to do is scale this according to your character, only the root bone. Use just this one. So once the scaling is done, you should align the bones approximately around here, the middle of the head, so the head bone will be here around the ears. So we are going to select again the root bone, going to the side view, and we are going to move it on the Y axis like so. Then we are going to use a tricky method, which is that we are going to align our currently existing rig with the unreal rig. So we are going to use mirror, we're going to select this, we're going to change this back. And we're going to quickly align this. Try to align your original armature as close as possible, because we really only want to move the tweak balls when it's really necessary. We don't want to go overboard with it, but you doesn't have to be extremely precise. We doesn't just rely on our original armature, because we are going to use the tweak ball as well in a second. Under your game rig tool tab, you should check this too. It's not necessary, but it will make your life easier. There is a really great stuff here under the utility tool, which show us the axis of the balls. That's really important in a case of unreal skeleton, because unreal is really whiny when it comes to even slightly rotated balls. So avoid rotation at all costs, instead rely on a location movement. And just like a trigify, try to avoid two disjoint balls that should belong together. Just one more thing to help ourselves regarding weight painting. I'm just going to show you what I exactly mean when you don't want to disjoint stuff. Like, for example, this bone. You should just select both of them here at the neck and move it together. So if you're moving together and we are going to move it down on the Z axis, then both bones are acting exactly how we want it. We are going to lower this one as well, just a tiny bit more. For best alignment, I would suggest this kind of setup, where you can see that this head bone is at the jaw. Okay, so let's go for the next step, which is we are going to object mode, then we are going to select our mesh, go into modifiers, I'm just going to apply this, and since I have eyes, I'm going to apply them as well. If you have any other stuff like hair or clothing or armor or anything, you can apply it right now. And just for good measure, I'm going to shade smooth this, and now we can delete our orgins because we are not needing them anymore. Now, here comes a really important phase, is that we will have to change the unit scale of the scene itself, because Unreal measures things in centimeters, Blender measures things in meters. And in order to have a perfect scene, we will need to change that to 0.01. And then we will have a perfect scene between Blender and Unreal. But before we do that, we should check that every object in the scene have the right scaling, which means that on the X, on the Y, and on the Z, they are all set to 1. So in my case, it's the character and the eyes. And as I can see, they are all 1, so it's all good. But how about the armature? If you check it, it's not 1, but exactly the number that we need to change the unit scale. And when we have changed the unit scale, and we will scale everything up, then you will see that this will be exactly 1. So the scaling will be correct. Now, let's see what happens. If we are changing to 0.01, as you can see, a few things has changed. You can barely see anything from the grid. That's because our mesh is currently really small compared to the scene. Now, that's what we will change right now, but first, set your cursor to world origin. For that, press Shift-S, cursor to world origin. Then we will scale everything up from the world origin. So when I go in here and select 3D cursor, that's where everything will be scaled up. So here I'm going to select the eyes, the mesh, and the rig. Then I'm going to press S and scale everything up by 100. And press Enter. And as you can see, now the scale is 100 for the eyes, for the character, but for the rig, it's exactly 1. Now, we can just go in, select the eyes, the character, and we are going to Object, apply all transforms. Now we apply the transforms, the origin of the eyes has went down to the 3D cursor. We can just go and set origin to geometry, and now they are all set back. Now once we are done with the scaling, we can continue with our game rig. And by the way, you don't have to worry that you scale the wrong armature or anything, because if you try to scale it, it does not do anything because currently it's controlled by the tweak bone. So don't worry about that. You just select your tweak bone and you're just going to apply rigging. Now we are going to hide the Unreal and the tweak one. We are going to check the scaling of this armature. We are going to Object, apply all transforms. And we are going to parent it to the bone. Now, as a matter of fact, I want to parent the eyes as well. Ctrl P, it automatically waits. Now let's check. Oh, and by the way, change this back to individual origins. And as you can see, it's working. Let's check the fingers as well. And let's check the neck. This is the more problematic part, where you most probably will have a slight problem with the head, because when you try to rotate it, it will do some weird stuff like this. Now, in this deform part, it's supposed to be a way painting part, but later on you can change the way painting in the next phase, in the last phase as well. So if you change your mind and you want to change the way painting, you can change it later on, but I'm just going to quickly fix that here. The best way to do this is going to select the armature, then the mesh, then you're going into way paint mode, then with Alt, you're holding Alt and clicking on the bone, you can automatically see the weight paint of each bone. Press Alt and clicking on the bones, you can see that it's a really great way for weight painting. How you need to fix that is really simple. On the head, we are going all in. And here, we are going here to the follow, select projected, and we are going to select also this one, so not just four faces. So we are going here and going also to wireframe. Okay, we are going to subtract. otherwise you will only need the headphone. So once we're done with that, it's the kick. Fair enough. Okay, we just reset its location. Oh, by the way, if you are having problems with the clipping, maybe you are seeing weird things of your character, then you should just lower the clip start and increase the end. Then it's all the it will be fixed. Okay, so next step is to go back to the game ring, and now we can just display and switch parent. We can go back to object mode and switch parent armature. Now it will automatically do the necessary steps. So when we are going to hide this, and we are going to select this one, check that the scale is right. It's not right, so we are going to object, apply, all transforms. Then we are going to the pose mode and check if it's correct or not. Seems like it's working. Now we are done with this. So the only thing left is to just export our character. So select your object that is parented to the armature, in my case, the eyes, the body, and last I'm going to select the armature. Then we are going to the file, export, export FBX. Here I already have my own setup. You can create your own with this plus icon, so you can do it from scratch, but I already have one. As you can see, it's already set up, but I'm going to show you how to create your own. So we are going to do restore defaults. Restore defaults, then I'm going to do selected objects. In apply scaling, we're going to select FBX custom scale. In forward mode, we are going to select X as forward. In up, we are going to select Z as up. We can leave these. We can go and set the smoothing to face. We don't want to apply the modifiers because if you have shape keys, as you can see, it prevents exporting shape keys. We don't want this, so we will uncheck. Because later on we will use ARKit shape keys, so we don't want to use that. So here we can just select only deform modes and no leaf modes. We don't need animations as well. And now if we did this, then we can just press and say Blender to UE 5.2. And now we have a saved version of this. As you can see, if we are going to restore the defaults and go here, as you can see, it all kept it like so. Now, only thing left is just press export FBX. Now, once you opened up your Unreal, you can go games, third person, and just going to hit create. Okay, once it's opened up, we can go to the content browser, create our new folder, save it. Oh. Maybe just move it here. For our own character, we're going to import. So here we are seeing our file. We are going to press open. In here, you are going to select the skeleton SK mannequin. When you want to import shapes, there is this three things that you must do. First is what we did at the export in Blender, which is you have to uncheck apply modifiers. The second one is that you have to check this to true. And the most important one is that the imported character or mesh have to have at least one mode. That is really important, otherwise Unreal doesn't recognize it as a skeletal mesh and therefore ignores more targets. But in other tutorials, I will get into that more deeply. Now we can go to third person blueprint, and we can change it here to our one. As you can see, we will compile it, save it, close it, then we are going to hit play, and there you have it.